In the immortal words of Gary Busey, I don't work on January the 8th, because that's Elvis's birthday. But I'm going to make an exception for Iran. In terms of crazy, Iran is the North Korea of the Middle East. It has that terrifying combination of just technologically advanced enough to build a nuclear weapon, just crazy enough to build one, and just crazy enough to use it. There are other countries that could build nuclear weapons. Japan could build a nuclear weapon next week using leftover Nintendo parts. But Japan doesn't want nuclear weapons. And there are other countries that have built nuclear weapons. The United States, Russia, France, China, the UK, Pakistan, India, Israel, and unfortunately, North Korea. The United States is the only nation that has used nuclear weapons against another nation. That was in 1945, nearly 75 years ago. In our time, Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan is threatening to use his country's nuclear arsenal against India. There's always a concern about North Korea because leaders whose names start with Kim Jong tend to have a very shaky grasp on reality. Iran is the last country on Earth you'd want to have a nuclear weapon, so we're all paying close attention as events unfold. On January 3rd, Iranian Major General Qasem Soleimani, commander of the Quds Force, was killed in a U.S. drone strike. Iranian leaders vowed to retaliate. Funerals for Soleimani took place January 4th through January 7th. On the 7th, 56 mourners were killed in a stampede at the funeral. Also on the 7th, I was working on a video all day, and I was deliberately ignoring the news. So I didn't even see the reports that Iran had launched missile strikes against two bases in Iraq where U.S. troops were stationed. I went live to talk about something completely unrelated, and people in the chat were telling me that two bases were hit with missiles and that 20 people were killed. I was shocked when I heard that 20 people were killed. It turned out not to be true. No one was killed in the Iranian missile strikes, but I thought it was true during my live stream. The reason so many deaths would be shocking is that there's no way Iran wants a war with the United States. In my video about the drone strike that killed Soleimani, I said that Iran was in an awkward position. If you know that the U.S. military is taking out your leaders, you probably don't want to retaliate in a way that's going to cause the U.S. military to take out more of your leaders. But at the same time, you have to retaliate because the U.S. military just took out the second most powerful man in your country. You can't let that slide. So what are you going to do? You have to come up with something that allows you to save face without convincing U.S. leaders to come at you even harder. So, when someone said that a bunch of people had been killed in an Iranian missile attack, it didn't make sense. Turns out the Iranians did exactly what I thought they'd do, retaliation without escalation. They launched missiles at two bases, knowing the missiles wouldn't kill anyone, because there are missile detection systems and everyone on the bases can go into bunkers. Iran is proclaiming that it gave the U.S. a good slap with this one, so Iranian leaders have saved face. But they didn't kill anyone. They basically put on a fireworks show. Apparently, Iranian funerals are far more dangerous than Iranian missile strikes. So, there's no good reason for the United States to respond with force. President Trump says he's going to impose stricter sanctions on Iran. There's now some concern that Iran will resume its quest to build a nuclear weapon. 2 days ago, President Trump tweeted, "Iran will never have a nuclear weapon." Now, this is true. No matter what the United States does, Iran will never have a nuclear weapon. I was in Israel a few months ago, and I talked to some IDF officers. In the news, we hear about Israel's conflicts with Syria and Hamas and so on. In Israel, the leaders view Iran as the real threat. At the end of the day, Hamas might be able to launch some terrorist attacks, but not the sort of attacks that would be a serious threat to the existence of Israel. Israel views Iran as an existential threat because Iran wants nuclear weapons. But because Israel is aware of the threat Iran poses, the IDF officers said that the chances of Iran getting a nuclear weapon are effectively zero. If Iran even gets close to building a nuclear weapon, Israel will blow its production facilities back to the Stone Ages. I don't always believe people when they say what they're going to do, but I believe these guys when they say there's no way they'll ever allow Iran to get a nuclear weapon. So, fortunately for the entire world, Iran won't have the devastating destructive capabilities it so desperately wants to have. It can instead return to its ongoing rivalry with Saudi Arabia as the two nations compete to see who will be the century's greatest state sponsor of terrorism.